Now to our story. You think you know the north side. So what comes to mind when you hear about the north side of Jacksonville? Million-dollar homes, farmlands, out-of-control crime?
All of those are true, depending on where you go. Here's how we know. A News for Jax viewer was a little disturbed with our headlines. Rob Kite wrote an email to the station and said, why is every story that occurs north of 8th Street considered the north side? He then said, this is a frequent occurrence and is incredibly frustrating to those of us north of the St. John's and around Ocean Way to be casually grouped in with areas that should not be labeled the north side. Do better. Well, after News 4 Jax responded to Rob's email, we decided to visit him and the north side to bust through some stereotypes.
The perceptions from many people that don't spend a lot of time on the north side are not always accurate.
Rob Kite says he was born and raised on Jacksonville's woods-covered north side. It's now a landscape of woods and homes with marsh views, sporadic farms, and new subdivisions.
And this is interesting. Rural on the right and suburban on the left.
New subdivision on the left. Yes, that is very, very common here.
But Kite says it's all overlooked based on people's assumptions, which he says have really hit home for his daughter in high school.
So it is disappointing when, you know, the students and even parents of students, you know, for a sleepover or something, you know, express concern that, oh, it's on the north side. You live on the north side. Like I've admitted readily, the north side is not all perfect, but the areas that we do take pride in, we would love to, you know, share with others.
This is the San Mateo area, just outside Ocean Way, smack in the middle of Jacksonville's largest zone. Police patrol the entire city by zone, and Zone 6 covers all the areas north of the Trout River from just west of US 1, New Kings Road, all the way east past Heckscher Drive. But there are parts of the north side that often make news headlines.
That breaking news alert is on the north side where police are investigating two separate shootings.
JSO is investigating a shooting on Airport Road.
That breaking news alert is on Jacksonville's north side, a 15-year-old who has been stabbed.
You want to tell us anything about your experiences on the north side?
Well, I was born and raised on the north side, and I wouldn't dare move back on the north side now.
Would you tell your friends come visit the north side? Is it?
No.
Oh, no? Why?
No. Because it's growing up so bad, and that's why I moved to Hilliard. It's just too busy. It's crime, and I mean, it gets worse every year.
One area of Zone 6 with the most calls for service is a very small subsector labeled P1. It's north of the Trout River, south of 295, in between Lem Turner Road and I-95. In that small subsector, during the month of October, the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office crime mapping tool shows most of the calls for service dealt with thefts and vehicle break-ins. Among the more violent crimes, most were physical assaults. Another hotspot for police calls is a small pocket off I-95 just east of the Jacksonville International Airport, near the River City Marketplace, where the dominant crime is theft. Travel just south of the Trout River and lines become blurred as people mistake the north side for parts of northwest Jacksonville, Zone 5, West 45th Street and Moncrief Road, Soutel Drive and New Kings Road, North Myrtle Avenue and the 20th Street Expressway. All these intersections are south of the Trout River in Zone 5, northwest Jacksonville.
So, have you ever been to the north side?
I actually live over there. So, it's crazy out there.
What part do you live in?
Over close to Edward Waters.
Okay. You know, it's interesting. That's actually part of northwest Jacksonville. It's like not considered like north side.
Back over on the north side, you'll find other more familiar sites. The Jacksonville Zoo off I-95 to the east and the Jacksonville International Airport off I-95 to the west. Way up north, between First Coast High School and the Caddyshack Ranch Wildlife Sanctuary.
You'll find homes that sit on probably about an acre of land.
Is the Dunn Creek community, where Navy veteran and local realtor Alvin Lyons chose to raise his family.
With Jacksonville being a large military town and the north side being centrally located to three of the bases here, that's kind of how I got here. Being close to the expressway as well as the airport, it's perfect for anybody who's always on the go, who's always traveling, or who just may have to get up and go at a moment's notice. It's the perfect place to be.
And so what do you say to people who are like, the north side, oh, that's where all shootings and things are happening, bad stuff?
I say, where? Point it out. You know, where do you live? Because I live on the north side, and it's nice.
As I explained, this was an email from Rob Kite that led us to bust some myths and stereotypes about the north side of Jacksonville. And when I met with Rob, not only was he thrilled his comments led to our story, but he was also surprised his initial email was answered by News 4 Jax anchor Tom Wills.
I was absolutely stunned that Mr. Wills responded. Yeah. He's been, you know, on the news channel since I've been alive. I mean, it seems like that at least. You know, since in the 70s as a kid, I remember seeing him. So it was very nice to get a response from him to see that he's still around.
And the one and only legendary Tom Wills is here with us now.
Rob is very, very young. As he said, I am still around. And because I've been around for such a, such a long time, I feel like I have not just a personal relationship with our viewers, but with many of them, it is a long personal relationship. And like both of you, I'm simply interested in what it is that the viewers are interested in. And when I hear from them, as I do from many, I write back to as many as I possibly can.
And, you know, you can contact us as well. We'll all write back. Just go to newsforjax.com/contact, and there you can send an email to the right person or department, depending on what you would like to share with us here at News 4 Jax.
Yes, and I think I speak for all of us, Tarek, Tom, all of us. We all appreciate the feedback we get from viewers. And I can tell you, I learned so much when we took our trip there through the entire north side. We didn't even have time in this story to talk about the little shops and eateries of the Alta Drive area or the solitude of Black Hammock, Little Talbot, Fort George Islands. If you would like to check out the different feels of Jacksonville's north side, just look for this story on newsforjax.com.